Hi guys, welcome back to Snails to Bowl Prana Yoga. Myself Mary, and today we'll be doing Nadi Shodhan, which is a form of pranayam. Now prana means life force or vital energy, and yama means regulation. So pranayam is a regulation of vital energy in our body through breathing. Now this prana or vital energy flows in our body through various channels, which are called as nadis, and through various energy centers, which are called as chakras. So Nadi Shodhan, Nadi meaning channels, and Shodhan means purifying. So Nadi Shodhan is a purification of energy channels in our body. It will help us in calming the mind as well as the body. So let's move on to the benefits of Nadi Shodhan. Nadi Shodhan will help us in calming the nervous system. Hence, it is beneficial both for children as well as adults, and as they are in a lot of stress as well as anxiety. It will also help us in detoxifying the body. It will decrease the heart rate as well as the blood pressure. It will also help us in improving the concentration. Now, when to perform it? Now, pranayam in general can be performed anytime during the day on an empty stomach, but it is preferably done early in the mornings just before breakfast. Nadi Shodhan is a form of relaxation pranayam. So it should be done after the more rigorous varieties, like you can do it after Kapalbhati. Okay, so now let's move on to the practice. So first we will sit either in the cross-legged position or the Sukhasana. We can also sit in the half lotus pose like this, or we can sit in the full lotus like this. We can also sit in Vajrasana. Okay, like this. Now I am more comfortable in the Sukhasana position or the cross-legged position, so I'll be sitting in Sukhasana. Okay, now regarding your posture, your spine will be lengthened, your back, head as well as the neck will be straight. Now the hand positions, your left hand will be in Gyan Mudra, that is your palm will be facing upwards, the tips of the index finger and the thumb will be touching each other like this. Okay, now your right hand will be used in controlling the breathing. So your right hand will be in Vishnu Mudra, that is your index finger and your middle finger will be folded onto the palm, and the remaining three fingers, that is the thumb, your ring finger and your little finger, will be straight. Okay, so now you will place your thumb on your right nostril and your little finger and your ring finger on your left nostril. Okay, now Nadi Shodhan usually involves a kumbhak, that is holding your breath in between your inhalations and exhalations. But we will first start with the beginner level, that is we will start with a ratio of 1:1, where we will do equal inhalation as well as exhalation. So if your example is, if you're inhaling for 4 counts, you will exhale for 4 counts. Okay, so let's begin with it. So we will place the thumb on the right nostril. Okay, now we will gently press the right nostril in order to block the right nostril. Okay, and we will inhale from the left nostril. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we will block the left nostril with the ring finger and exhale through the right nostril. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we inhale through the right nostril. 1, 2, 3, 4. We will block the right nostril with the thumb and exhale through the left nostril. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now this completes round 1. We will do a few more rounds. Okay, so blocking the right nostril, we will inhale through the left nostril. 1, 2, 3, 4. Blocking the left nostril, we will exhale through the right nostril. 1, 2, 3, 4. Inhale through the right nostril. 1, 2, 3, 4. Blocking the right nostril, we will exhale through the left nostril. 1, 2, 3, 4. This completes round 2. We'll do one more round. Inhale through the left. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now exhale through the right. 1, 2, 3, 4. Inhale through the right. 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale through the left. 1, 2, 3, 4. So like this, you can do 8 to 10 rounds. You can do it 2 to 3 times a day for 15 to 20 days. And then you can move on to the next level. That is, now we can do a ratio of 1:2. That is, if you are inhaling for 4 counts, you will exhale for double the counts. That is 8 counts. Okay? Then after progressing from this ratio of 1:2, suppose if you're performing it for 15, 20 days and you're quite confident, then you can move on to the next ratio and involve a kumbhak. That is, as I told you previously, it is breath holding in between your inhalations as well as exhalations. Now, when you're involving kumbhak, you can initially start with a ratio of 1:2:2. That is, you can, if you are inhaling for 4 counts, you will exhale for 8 counts and you will hold your breath for 8 counts. Okay, so let's begin with it. So you will block your right nostril and inhale from the left. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you will block both the nostrils and hold your breath for 8 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now you will exhale through the right nostril. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now you will close both the nostrils and hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now you will inhale through the right nostril. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you will close both the nostrils and hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now you will exhale through the left nostril. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You will hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now this completes round 1. So similarly, you will do 8 to 10 rounds, do it for 2 to 3 times daily for a period of 15 to 20 days, unless you move on to the next level. Now in the next level, you will increase the duration of your kumbhak. Okay, that is, you will do it now in the ratio of 1:4:2. That is, if you are inhaling for 4 counts, you will hold your breath for 16 counts and you will exhale for 8 counts. Okay guys, now for the Nadi Shodhan, just a few pointers that when you are inhaling and when you are exhaling, your breathing should be smooth and it should be prolonged. It should be deep. It should not be jerky like this. You're not going to do like this, okay? We've already done deep and slow breathing in the practice now. So now you know how it feels like, okay? So that's it guys, we are done with today's session. Do practice Nadi Shodhan over a period of time, then only it will give you maximum benefits. Share your experiences with us and let us know how you feel. Also, do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Until then, stay fit, stay safe.